Some people, them envy you. Follow you on Insta just to pre you. The way that go chat rubbish, the way that go spoil your name behind you. You buy one thing, they go on buy two.
The very first thing you do is find the back of the gele and make sure you're turning from the front to the back. Once you finish turning the tips, you then place it on the head. So you'll be using your index finger and your thumb to tie this gele, and those two fingers are the two most important fingers. Firstly, you're going to hold it with your thumb, like try and hold it tight. Then going in with those two index fingers, at the same time, start pulling in material from the back forward. And each time you pull it forward, you hold it with your thumb. As you're doing this, try to drag it and make it as tight as you can. This is very tricky, but if you get it right, it makes all the difference. Now that I have 5 plates, I'm going to ask her to hold it on one side while I go ahead and extend the plates on the other side, line after line.
And God bless you, they don't want to celebrate you. When you tell them good news, they know one day happy for you. Only God knows what kind of bitterness.
Again, I'm going to ask her to hold it while I extend the plates on the other side. At this point, I'm going to ask her to hold it again, so she'll be holding both sides. As you can see, our 5 plates are visible. That's what you want. Now, following the pleats, I'm going to drag the shorter side up. While also following the pleats, I'm going to cross the longer side underneath the shorter side to drag it all the way to the other side. I know I'm saying a lot of sides, but I hope you guys get what I'm trying to say. So you ask her to hold the shorter side because you need that side real tight while you try to form more clips with the longer side. Putting your hand inside the material, we're going to go through the whole process again of forming clips. So, but this time around, one finger, your index finger, is holding it on one side, and then the rest of your fingers are trying to form it from inside the material. Again, slowly, I'm going to try and extend the pleats. I know it gets more difficult at this time because this is where most of our athletes start losing pleats. Me, myself, today, I still lose pleats sometimes. But I try as hard as I can to follow each line. It gets easier, I guess, the more you do it.
Some people, them envy you. Follow you on Insta just to pre you. The way that go chat rubbish.
At this point again, you need her to hold it by the side real tight. And this is probably the most important time for her to hold it, because you're about to tie it at the back. And if it's not held tight, then everything you've just done is going to scatter. Seriously speaking, they need to hold it real tight. Then as you can see, we're holding it all from the short side. Then from that longer side that went all the way through the front, you're going to start gathering it, just leaving a little bit at the tips because you want it to form a round shape.
You cannot steal my joy. You cannot steal my joy. Steal my joy. You never ever ever ever.
Then you tie it real tight. Then after you tie it, now the form part actually begins. Like, this is my favorite part, it's the easiest part. I'm going to start folding. Basically, you just try to focus in the middle. Fold it as neatly as you can. As you can see here, I'm just trying to form lines in the middle. Like, using my fingers, I push the material in and then grab it with my thumb to form the folds.
God bless you, they don't want to celebrate you.
when there is no more room to fold, you just drag everything forward basically so that it goes with the pleats you've already previously formed. Again, this part is important. Before you extend your pleats, you have to use one hand to hold it in the middle, because if you don't hold it tight here, then everything is going to scatter. So while holding it, I'm going to try extending each line of the pleat. I'm going to basically use my finger, push it from the back, and then use my thumb to line it all the way down, making it go from center to the side. I'm just trying to follow the lines that were already formed in the middle. So I'm just dragging it from each line in the middle to the left or to the right. As you can see, one side is already looking nice, and now we're going to move over to the other side. You just try and make it look as nice as you can. So after you've done that, then the gele is done. I'm going to retie the second knot at the back again, but before you do that, you can choose if you want it to be a covered gele or an open one. Some people want to cover their hair, so you pull this material all the way down, then tie it or pin it in, or if you want it open, you just fold it. So this is what it's going to look like when you're done. Hope you guys enjoyed watching this video and hope you learned one or two things. Don't forget to subscribe, thumbs up, and share this video, and I will see you all in my next video.